Was there a definitive moment that you thought, yeah, I want to get into voice acting, or was it accidental, Erika? How did you start getting there?
Well, I always tell this story, and my mom thinks it's hilarious now that I tell this story at conventions. So I was watching Kim Possible when I was a kid, and the Disney Channel, I don't know if they still do this, but they used to go on commercial breaks, and they would sometimes have like behind the scenes stuff with their actors. And so the actress for Kim Possible was doing one of those, and she was like, voice acting's great because I get to go to work in my pajamas. And I was in my pajamas at the time. So I was like, that's great, I wanna do that. And so my mom walked in and I was like, hey, I decided what I wanna be when I grow up. I was like 9. And she was like, that's wonderful. And I was like, a voice actor. And she was like, oh, that's not a real job. And then she continued on into the house. And I was like, oh, okay. But I never really like, forgot that I forgot what it was after a while, but it was always like somewhere in me. So in college, when I saw a voice acting class, I was like, that's a thing I thought was a thing at some point. And and then the teacher was very encouraging. It was Tony Oliver, who directs me in a ton of stuff now. And he was like, you should do this for a career. And I was like, haha,
that's a great
told you so, mom.
Pajamas. I like that the driving force was pajamas.
Yeah, it really was. And I never got to do it in my pajamas until the pandemic. Then I exclusively recorded in my pajamas.
Oh, so you didn't even get to do it in your pajamas?
She lied to me.
It's a lie.
Yes, it was a lie.